Hey guys, and welcome back to my channel. For today's video, I'm gonna be testing a new brand to my channel, a new brand to me, and I'm super excited about it. This video is sponsored by the brand Florasys, and they did send over a few of their makeup items to try, so I could put it on for you, kind of do this whole look, show you how everything looks, swatches, how it wears as well, and my opinions on some of these products. I have been hearing so much hype about this brand because of their packaging. They have the most gorgeous packaging, which you guys will see here in some of their products. And I've seen countless videos of people trying them out and actually really enjoying the brand. So I also thought it would be fun to try them out. And we're gonna be putting on almost a full face today. So I do wanna tell you guys a little bit about the brand here. I'm just gonna read off of their site, but they are a fast-growing, innovative makeup brand. Born by the West Lake in China, our vision is to shake up the cosmetics market with Eastern beauty by bringing global users the most aesthetic and natural makeup products. We develop healthy and nourishing cosmetic products that contain herbal extracts and a lot of other caring ingredients. Our brand value is to inspire global users with Florasys traditional beauty rituals, Eastern aesthetics, philosophy, and modern technology. So very cool. You guys know me, I do love my natural makeup, so I did pick out a couple things to use today. Some of their best sellers we're going to be trying on the face. So let me go ahead and get into the products. So the thing I'm probably most excited to try and I've been so curious about is their eyeshadow palette. So they sent this one over and oh my gosh, check out this box. This is insane. It's this gorgeous like fan kind of packaging, but it also kind of looks like a seashell a little bit with the holographic opalescent glitter. This is a gorgeous case. And then you open it up and you have your eyeshadow palette inside, also in the shape of a fan. Here is the outside of the palette. And then as you open it up, you get 9 eyeshadows in here. These can also be used as well on the face for other uses like blush, bronzer, all of that. This is the Encounter palette. They do have a few other ones on their website. They're always coming out with new collections. And what's so unique about their shadows is that they're placed in kind of this different setup here, but they have engravings on them on the inside. I'll have the prices up here on the screen as well. I think you do have to order on their website. As far as I know, I don't think they sell really anywhere here in the States, but you can definitely order online. Next up, I'll show you guys this product. This is kind of a little face palette, and it's very similar to the eyeshadow palette. This is their Eastern Beast Sculpting Makeup Palette. It's a 4-in-1 palette for a natural sculpting look with contour, highlighter, blush, and eyeshadow. You could use it as all of the above, which is nice. So opening this one up, I think this is absolutely beautiful. I would use this as bronzer. There's also blush. There's like a matte highlight and then a matte shimmer, but again, if this is not your tones, they can also work as eyeshadows as well. I'll be testing these out on the face today, but this would also make a great little small eyeshadow palette. I'm also going to be testing their powder today, and this is the Gorgeous Peach Blossom Silk Powder, which looks like this. It has this little compact that opens up here. You do get a little sponge with this one, and it's just a mattifying, very blurring powder here. I'm really excited about this one because I do have oily skin, so I always need a good matte powder. They also sent over a couple of their eyeliners here. Sonian Tracing Eyeliners. I have the shade number 1 and shade number 2. These are a very pretty dark teal, almost black packaging here with rose gold accents. And they do have a very fine tip. Shade number 2 is a light brown liquid liner. And then shade number 1 is the black in the collection. So those are the 2 liquid liners. And then we also have their Flawless Jade Shine Liquid Lipsticks. These are also gorgeous. They have white packaging with rose gold accents, and you can see the colors on the bottom. So I have a few shades. I'll go ahead and swatch. First shade is the G401, which is a light peach. These are kind of a shiny liquid lip, just as they are described. I also have G403, which is, I would say, a tad bit darker than the first one. And then G502, which is more of like your red color. So those are the 3 lip products that I have. I love the packaging too. It feels expensive because it just snaps together so nice. And then lastly, we have this cute little lip balm in this tub here. Kind of reminds me of like the Tatcha ones. But how cute, it has this little scooper as well. So it definitely looks more luxurious and it is more sanitary. It says you can apply thickly at night. It exfoliates and minimizes lip lines. You can use it thin for daily use as well to hydrate your lips. I almost forgot to mention these lip products as well, the Blooming Rouge Love Lock lipsticks. These are the pearl edition, so they actually come with this cute little keychain. I love the detail here, gorgeous packaging. It pushes open and the lipstick pops out. They even have a design on the inside, kind of like how the palettes do, which is so much fun. I'm trying the shade 521, yes I do, out first, which is a kind of pinky rose, and I also tried out the 520, which is more of a true red called I Love You. Really cute names. This is a nice matte formula. It's not drying on the lips, but it's not shiny either. It just gives you that matte look that actually stays on throughout the day.
So that's a quick look at the products. Let's go ahead and I'll show you guys how I did this look today, and we're gonna test everything out for the first time. So to start this try on, I think we're gonna start with the lip mask here. Since it's kind of like a skincare thing, we'll let that sit on the lips just to get them hydrated. I love that it has the little scoop. And then I'm just gonna put my finger on the scoop and apply it this way. This is very minty. It is a thicker balm, so it definitely feels more like a mask, but it feels so smooth and I feel like it really like fills in any lines and stuff. I wouldn't say it's really plumping. Now it's starting to smell a little more floral. So it started out minty. It's almost rosy in a way, where it kind of reminds me of like the By Terry lip balm a little bit, but it feels really, really moisturizing. So lips are prepped. We're gonna let that sit. Let's actually move to the eyes next, because I just can't wait to get into the palette. So the first shade I'm gonna take is this big one here, this matte down here with like the horse printed on here. I'm gonna put this in the crease. This shade is definitely on the lighter side, but it will be nice to kind of blend out some darker colors and just kind of using it as a starter, because it's not like super dark or anything. So let's build that up even more. I'm gonna take this kind of burnt reddish brown and build that on top. This one's pretty pigmented. It looks very true to color as it does in the pan, and it seems to be blending out pretty good. Okay, next let's try out this darker brown, and we're gonna place this in the outer corner. I feel like with these kind of indents in the palette and like designs, I do have to pick up a little bit more product on my brush and just kind of rub it in a bit more to make sure it's coating. But it is building up quite nicely. It's not super dark. I would say this is more of like a medium depth, but it looks like we can build it up to get to where we want it to be. I'm actually gonna mix these two browns here and put this on my lower lash line. I'm gonna leave the inner portion open because I might try something different there. Next, for shimmers, we're gonna see how these perform. So I actually wanna take this one. It's like a pinky gold here. It looks gorgeous. And I'm gonna use the flat brush. I just put some setting spray on it, and then we'll dip into the color. And I'm trying to kind of get my brush in there. I know, ruining the design a little bit and just packing that on. Ooh, that's gorgeous. Right on the middle. I feel like I see these kind of colors a lot in palettes where it looks really pink, but then when you put it on the eyes, it's definitely more golden. I wish it had just a little bit more pink to it, but I know those kind of duochrome-ish colors can be a little bit deceiving. I'm actually gonna go over top of that with my finger to kind of smooth everything out, and it just kind of pops a little bit more punch. As you can see the difference there. I do this with pretty much all my shimmers because I love a really metallic, shiny lid. And then just going back with my Sephora brush and blending any edges here. Next, I'm taking a really small, almost liner brush. This is from Ruffer, and I'm going to dip into the blue. I kind of want to experiment here and try popping this like on the lower lash line corner. I actually switched brushes to the same one we used for the lid. This one's picking up product a little bit better. that's pretty much what I'm doing for the eyes. Let me go in with their liquid liner here and just kind of place this. I might try to attempt a wing here. I'm just adding a baby wing. Really easy eyeliner to use. I suck at winged liner, and I feel like that was pretty fast and pretty easy. So I'm actually gonna put my foundation on. I don't have one from them, and then I'm gonna try out one of their powders. Okay, now that our foundation and concealer are on, we're gonna try out this powder. This is their Gorgeous Peach Blossom Silk Powder. It's supposed to give a matte finish and give you just this flawless airbrush look, and it's also waterproof, which I'm really curious about. It is pretty hot here, so we'll definitely put this to the test. But I'm just gonna kind of pat this all along my face. But overall, it's definitely giving a matte appearance. It's taking away all the shine that I had from my skin tint that we used, which is awesome for oily skin because I always like my skin to start out super matte because my oils are gonna come back throughout the day. So that's why I don't add too much glow in the beginning. But it does look pretty flawless, pretty airbrushed. Everything looks very perfected. Okay, next we're going into more of the cheek palette, which is absolutely gorgeous. I'm really excited to try this one out as well. So let me see if I can try and concentrate my brush here in this kind of more bronzer looking quad and do the cheekbones. This has a really nice neutral, almost cool leaning undertone. I'll have to see if they have some more shades in this because this one's definitely perfect for my skin tone. But yeah, I really like the tone of this. It actually kind of reminds me of the Charlotte Tilbury, the Film Star Bronze and Glow, the color that's in that. I feel like this is very comparable. Just getting underneath the chin here. I do a little sides of the nose and the forehead just to bronze up a bit. Let's try the blush here. This is a pretty kind of rose. It's very natural. The pigment's also really nice here on the blush. Really smooth formula again. I am gonna set my face with some setting spray. And then we'll do the highlight on top of that. There's actually two kind of highlight options here. One's actually more matte, which is interesting, but we're gonna go with the shimmer. Oh yes, that's beautiful. It's super beaming too, so we'll definitely have to kind of calm it down a bit. I haven't worn like crazy highlight in such a long time. It looks really good too over texture. There's no glitter or anything, so really, really impressed, honestly, with the cheek palette. And I feel like with that matte shade, that's gonna be such a nice like brow bone highlight. So maybe we'll do that with that color. And like inner corner highlight. Ooh yeah, that's nice. I don't think they sent over a mascara, so I went ahead and did my own, but now we're moving on to the last step, which is lips. And I'm gonna use their Dew and Jade like glowing lip gloss. I'm gonna go for more of the darker color, be a little more bold, which I think will look really pretty with this eye look. This says G502. I'm not sure if it has an actual name, but let's see what this formula is like because it says it's a gloss. Oh wow. This is like those YSL glossy lip stains a little bit. So it was super easy to apply even with a darker red like this. It looks a lot darker here. Like this looked like it was gonna be burgundy, but on my lips, it's more of like a true red, like a popsicle red is what it's giving. But it's a really comfortable formula. This is not gonna be transfer proof. Of course, it is glossy, but it covers everything. It looks pretty on the lips. And yeah, it reminds me of like those glossy lip stains. I'll have to see if it does stain the lips too. But I think it looks really pretty with this eye look. And I don't wear a whole lot of reds, so something a little bit different I figured I would try today. So here is our makeup look for today. Just a little bit of some, I would call this a neutral glam with a red lip. Very classic, great for a day or evening. But let's go ahead and I'll kind of give my thoughts on each of the products so far. All right guys, let me give my thoughts on the products here. I have to say my favorite thing I tried is probably honestly the face palette, just because I love that it's kind of an all-in-one. I love that you can also use this for eyeshadow. Colors were natural but also pigmented. They were very smoothing. I really liked the formulas in here, and I think it is very comparable to high end. Like, it totally reminded me of like something Charlotte Tilbury would come up with the formulas and the colors. I really, really like this a lot, and it does feel very luxurious. The packaging, even like the closing of them, it feels really nice. So this is my top favorite thing that we tried out. I also really love these lip products too. These are so nice. I did go ahead and blot, and these do stain the lips. So they're gonna give you full opacity. They have the beautiful shine, and they do leave a stain behind, which is nice to wear for long periods of time. They're super comfortable. These are probably my second favorite. I am a lip junkie, and I was definitely very impressed with these. The eyeshadow palette is gorgeous as well. This was definitely more on the neutral side, of course, but I do love my neutrals. The mattes were very pretty, really easy to blend out formula-wise, but I think all around the look is very flattering, something I would wear for every day. Of course, it's not the most unique color scheme out there. I do kind of wish I could have played with that blue a bit more, since it didn't show up a ton underneath when I had that idea, but I think all over the lid it would be really pretty. And then I wish this one was just a little bit more pink, so I wish I had just a little bit more color, but I think on their website they do have some more colorful palettes, so the palette definitely worked for us. I do wish maybe it had a little deeper colors though too, just to build up a little bit more depth, but overall the quality was great on this. The liquid liners, they worked pretty well too. I haven't really had much smudging or anything. There's so many liquid liner formulas on the market though, I don't really feel like I need another one, but if you're looking for one, you're on the website, this is a nice one. Like, it was so fast and easy to do our wing today, which it usually takes me forever, and it could just be that I had a good liner day. Sometimes I have bad liner days, but it did work pretty well and did the job. As well as the powder, I actually am really liking this one too. I definitely have to put this one to the test a bit more just for long wear and all of that, but it really did mattify the skin. But it's not like cakey, it's not looking like dry or anything like that. It, like, my natural oils are coming through. It does look really pretty, but it gives me the matte that I like in the beginning with also the blurring properties that it has. I think it's a pretty powder. I'm excited to try a bit more. I could see this one kind of being a staple in my purse, like to travel with and just take with me everywhere to touch up. And the lip mask as well, I definitely love the packaging. I think it feels very high quality. I did think it was weird that it started out as a mint smell and then it went more into a rose scent, but it felt really nice. My lips do feel really good with this mask. Love to see if they come out with some tinted ones. I think that could be fun. I'm all about like the lip tints just for every day. It did make the lips feel and look very hydrated. So that's an overview of all of the products here. Definitely really excited to be able to try this brand. If you've been curious about it, I think it's worth checking out, especially if you're a sucker for packaging and design like I am. That's one of my favorite things with makeup, is just the beauty of it all. Definitely go snag that face palette and the lippies as my favorite products from today's video. Let me know if you guys have tried anything from Florisis or if you plan to. I'm super curious. I'm gonna go ahead and let you guys go. Thanks so much for watching, and I'll see you guys in my next video. Bye guys.